Hey everyone, this is Power to Mario alongside MegFreak 400 in downtown Chicago.
What? No, we're in Crevice Cave. And
Oh, yes.
You might be wondering, why does this music sound familiar? Because this is the music from Foggy Forest, I think? I think it's Foggy Forest. Or something similar to that. But basically, for this area, the music is all is just a jukebox, basically. It's a jukebox of any music, I believe.
Cool.
I think it's just anything from the main storyline. It just it randomly changes. There are other dungeons we'll encounter later that do this, but this one doesn't seem to. Well, it's the only one in the main story that does this, like in terms of, you know, how these are technically post-story missions.
Yes.
It's the only one that does this in the main story. And I encountered another one, and the jukebox in that dungeon, it was a forest dungeon, and all of them were forest themed. Here it just seems kind of random. But anyway, Crevice Cave, I'll go in detail of what you can find here. There are 14 floors with a relay point or a, a rest stop between floors after floor 10, and there are traps. The main type is still ice, and you can recruit at this point. Pokemon you can find here are Golduck, Jinx, Meryl, Azumarill, Sneasel, Swinub, Piloswine, Delibird, Smoochum, Slackoth, Vigoroth, Slaking, Azurill, Nosepass, Swablu, Altaria, Zangoose, Snowrunt, Piplup, Printplup, Empoleon, Snover, Weevil, Glaceon, Mamoswine, and that's in the upper Crevice Cave. In the lower Crevice Cave, you can find pretty much the same thing plus. Oh, that sucks. They didn't tell what Pokemon were added. They just were like, oh yeah, you can find these Pokemon as well. Maybe it's about the same.
That's a lot of Pokemon.
Weevil, Snover, Zangoose. Did I say Zangoose in the original?
I believe so.
Yeah, I guess they're about the same for the most part.
They all have the ability to use ice moves?
Not,
I guess that's the basic requirement.
Well, not all of them, do they?
I'm pretty sure. I think Zangoose, isn't there? There's a ice punch, or I think you can learn ice punch, Zangoose.
Possibly. And yeah, see here, this is the desert music, and it's playing in an ice level.
Well, technically, any area in the world that is pretty much void of precipitation can be considered a desert.
Yeah, technically Antarctica is a desert because it doesn't rain as much there. Which most people don't know that. It's one of the few things I remember from. Not few things, but you know, I'm more an English guy and more a history guy. Science I like to an extent, but I don't, you know, I'm not really into it. But I remember from science class that was one thing that was always mentioned, that deserts are low precipitation.
Yeah, this would be considered an ice desert. And there's also sand deserts and I believe salt deserts.
Well, no, actually this would be considered a cave.
Okay. the area outside. A blizzard. Blizzards are precipitation.
No, but this is Crevice Cave though. This is a cave, man.
It's a cave desert.
There are no cave deserts. I think you need a nap.
I think I need battery charge in my brain. Dude, there's a lot of Pokemon here. Actually, Mega, you showed me the one of the Japanese trailer videos, trailer compilation videos for the new Pokemon Mystery Dungeon.
Well, it wasn't a compilation. It was just a. Well, I guess
I thought there was like multiple three videos in one video. I thought that's what it was. It's kind of how it looked like.
I don't know. I think that's just how Japanese trailers do that. They kind of have like quick cuts between stuff.
Oh, okay.
I don't know, but it was just one video, but yeah, there is a new Pokemon Mystery Dungeon coming out, and it's actually in full 3D, which I kind of like the sprites here, but it does look nice for being on the. It's for the 3DS, and it's using Gen 5 Pokemon. The selection's actually quite smaller than I believe at the moment. The selection of, you know, how you can have like a bunch of different Pokemon that you can be like Munchlax and. Shinx and
Meowth in the former. Yeah. And I'm sure I've actually think it might look a little bit better on the 3DS XL. It's called XL, right?
Yeah.
The bigger top screen.
Mm-hmm.
It'll probably look better on that one because just the expanded screen, the 3D models might look a little bit better.
Yeah, well, the thing is, you have to keep in mind with any 3DS, or any game in general for that matter, everything looks better in person on TV or on your 3DS. You can look at videos, for example, of like Paper Mario Sticker Stars coming out. You can look at videos of that, but playing it on your 3DS, it's going to look better than videos. It always is the case. I've noted. It's just how it works.
Oh yeah, Zangoose can learn a few ice type moves: Ice Beam, Blizzard, Ice Punch, mm-hmm. Icy Wind.
I never use a lot of Gen 3 Pokemon. I don't know. Gen 3 is always my mystery, or not mystery, but it's always the one I just kind of.
It's slowly sinking in, but I think I like Gen 3 the best out of every Pokemon generation so far.
There are people who seem to be that way. I know one guy who's like, no, like a lot of people don't like Gen 3, but they find Gen 3 to be the best. And it's, you know, there's nothing wrong with Gen 3. It's just, Gen 3 just is kind of, I don't know, it doesn't stick out in my mind as much as any of the other generations.
I kind of wonder why that is, though. I never really thought about what kind of detracts it for people. What makes it not as good? Is it maybe that you think maybe the story is just cut and dry, black and white?
It's not the story. I don't know why. I guess one thing is it followed Gold and Silver, which many consider like one of the best. A lot of people consider that one of the best Pokemon games. Not to mention the fact that Heart Gold and Soul Silver, when that came out, I know even more people who consider that to be the best Pokemon game to date. It pretty much improved or pretty much refined everything that made Pokemon Pokemon. My one friend wasn't really into like the new gen Pokemon, and he played Heart Gold and Soul Silver, and he loves that series. So I think following that probably didn't help it any. You know what I mean? It follows a game that a lot of people really like, and a game that's still focused on Kanto and Johto and all that, and then they move in a whole new region without Oak. Oak isn't in those games. There's like it does kind of, I don't know. It's something's jarring about it, I guess. I will admit though, there's not really anything that screams this game is. It's not like it's bad. It's just, I don't know. I'm not really sure. I can't really answer that question because I'm not really sure why it doesn't stick out in my mind. It just doesn't.
I'll try to pull one thing out. When I played Pokemon Diamond, I have a copy of Diamond. I played Platinum too. Mm-hmm. One thing I really don't like what Game Freak and Nintendo did with the Pokemon franchise, at least the version games. They added a lot of extras, like busy work
such
modes. Like in fourth gen, they had that underground thing.
I never used that. You didn't need to use that.
I know they had that. What else did they have in 4th gen? They had... Oh! They introduced this in 3rd gen, but it was very basic. The contest.
Yeah.
Contest. That was something I wasn't too fond of.
But you
either.
Can just ignore them. You don't have to do the contest.
That's
true. I never did. No, the most useless thing added to Pokemon is in Gen 5, and you haven't experienced it, but it's not really like major spoilers, and you said you're not even interested in the game. Basically, you know how like Gen 4 had the contest. I think there's something else that Gen 4 had that was...
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
There was something... some other extra they added in Gen 4. But anyway, in Gen 5, there's Pokemon musicals. And that is without a doubt the most pointless thing. I did it. You just go in, dress up your Pokemon, and they dance. And that's
it.
There's
that in the trailers, but I didn't know what that was.
There's no point to it. And maybe there's more, but it's really, really stupid.
Gen 6 is gonna introduce Shakespearean adaptations.
Like, it's silly and it's fun to do once, but it's entirely pointless unless I'm missing something, unless there's like some greater cause, but it's not even like, you know, in contest you can kind of, I was gonna say contest, I think you can kind of influence decisions, but the one thing I actually like that they added in Heart Gold and Soul Silver, did you get those games?
I have Soul Silver.
The sports arena.
Yes. That one was fun. I like that.
Yeah.
That was probably that's probably the only thing I like, fourth gen wise that they added as a bonus thing to do, because you could earn items.
Yeah.
You could earn really nice
items. And it was fun, too. It was fun to play the minigames.
Yep. So, I love that one. I haven't honestly played... I'm becoming more and more the spin-off fan. I used to just play the version games till the cartridges ran out of... Their batteries run out. Thank you, Ruby and Sapphire, for doing that.
See, I don't know what... I think you just have bad luck with Pokemon in general, because for me, my Ruby cartridge got to the point where it says, oh, your clock is no longer working, which is what you said happened to yours.
Oh, no. I don't think it was the clock. It was just... It would not keep a save file.
Well, because mine says... Because I think you remember you saying that that's what started it, but for me, mine says, okay, the battery's, like, low, or your battery died, you can no longer... use the clock, but I can still save and play the whole game through without any trouble.
Yeah, I couldn't save, period. Like, it would have the last save I had on my Ruby file when I was doing the Let's Play was the save I had at the Pokemon Center before you went through Victory Road.
Mm-hmm.
And every time I would shut off my game and try to save and then reload it, it would go back to that original save before the
You could have just never not turn it off. I know, like, one guy who...
Yeah, and then... And I did that. But then, you know what it started doing? Midway through the game, about 10 seconds after it would start, the screen would turn black.
Well, that's not good.
That's not good either. That's like, okay. So I can just... I thought that. I could just keep it going and going and just finish off the Elite Four.
I hate that when you think you're being clever and you think you can do something to solve your problem and then...
The game's like, no,
screw you. You're not playing this.
You're not getting off that easy.
What music is this from?
Oh, let me think. I don't remember.
It must have been in your part, because I feel like when we're doing this Let's Play, I feel like your entire section, I meant from the Groudon, the whole expedition, I just kind of blanked on, because I don't even remember much of what happened in that section. And it wasn't in the future or anything, and I don't think it was in the last section either, so I'm not sure.
Not Waterfall Cave. Not Waterfall Cave.
No.
Could it be a crystal cave or a crystal crossing?
I don't think it's Crystal Crossing. Then again, I could be entirely wrong.
And the thing I missed out on is when I was... I admit, when we were doing the earlier videos, I had the volume kind of set low.
Well, yeah, but when you record it, you don't listen to game music when you record?
I heard it, it wasn't loud enough sometimes when I was recording, because I wanted to hear you. Your lovely voice. But for the latter half of the Let's Play, I did do that, so I'll be able to recognize some of the later levels. Here is the pit.
Yes, and look, it's Scizor, but he's frozen.
Huh? Teehee.
Now, here's probably the most stupid, I guess stupid... Pointless, weird boss. Weirdest boss choice. Frostlass, which we actually found in, I believe, Crystal Caves, Crystal Crossing, you can actually encounter Frostlass, and now there's a Frostlass as a boss here. Which is fine, but, yeah, not going to be that difficult of a boss.
Yeah, so basically your strategy here is to use fire moves. Fire.
I use Violet Seed.
Or that. That's cool too. Ominous Wind.
I hate Ominous Wind because it attacks your entire party.
Is that a psychic move?
I think it's Ghost.
Yeah, you're probably right. I think you just hit the nail on the head. It's probably Ghost.
Because I think Frostlass is part Ghost. Maybe. I possibly. Let me check.
Ominous Wind.
Yeah, Frostlass is Ice Ghost.
Yeah. That's how she rolls, man. I'm guessing this is a she.
Yeah.
It's Frostlass. I think it's only female, honestly.
I think you're right, because I think that's how you have to evolve it, is via it being female. But the thing that was really annoying with this battle, as you can see, is Ominous Wind. And there's... I remember I was doing a mission where you had to escort a Pokemon, and a lot of the Pokemon in this dungeon that we haven't actually gone to yet knew Ominous Wind, so it would pretty much wipe out that low-level Pokemon every time. So Ominous Wind is pretty annoying just because it hits your entire team, but even with Ominous Wind, process isn't that hard. I was getting pretty unlucky with this battle.
That Thunderbolt, man, I'm getting rid of it. It's gone. Goodbye.
I didn't have too much. Well, this is when I think I switched to Shockwave it, or maybe. Because, see, Shockwave wouldn't miss here. It would just hit it and kill him. And instead, he's using Thunderbolt.
Yeah. Lightning Bolt.
Yeah, there we go.
Lightning Bolt. Lightning Bolt. Oh, dear, Pikachu.
And
oh, well, finishing blow. Good job. Eek. That's all you have to say? You're a villain.
Yeah, Frostus is a female-only species because... And Gallade is the male counterpart, even though Gallade can be both, technically.
I was frozen for 1,000 years.
Yeah, so Scizor was a really awesome explorer, but... And, you know, when Mr. Mime talked to us about this, you think he would realize that it's quite possible Scizor could be dead. But no, Scizor has been frozen in time, and...
Yeah, that would suck.
What, being frozen in
if
time?
You just unfreeze him, and then he just collapses, and he doesn't move. Like, oh.
Oh, well, he's dead. But no, he actually is, now the future has happened, and I don't know how... Really, this world doesn't look that futuristic, you know what I mean? So I don't know how, like... How far in the past was he that everything looks different and strange? But he is going to give us a reward for saving him. And this is not going to come into play until after all of this is, I don't know, maybe you could do it now, but I think you have to finish all the post-game to actually start doing this. But basically, he's going to give us a, he's going to say it.
An honorary membership.
No, he's an honorary member, but he's going to give us a secret rank. And basically, yeah, I know he didn't say it yet, but yeah, I was sick of him waiting for him. Secret Rank basically allows us to go to dungeons that will allow us to recruit legendary Pokemon that we normally couldn't go to. I think you need to use still Wonder Mail codes and stuff, but having the rank allows you to actually go to the dungeons, I believe. I don't know all the details in that, so if anyone knows more, feel free to tell me. But I know that's what it involves, is the legendary Pokemon, like Mew and Rayquaza and...
This gives us the potential for off-screen Wonder Mail abuse.
Possibly. Though I don't know if we'll show all of them, because there's a lot of legendary Pokemon.
So we can have a team of Zapdos, Articuno, and Moltres, and just wreck every single post-game dungeon.
Eat four Pokemon. Add in Lugia, because...
Mewtwo.
No, Lugia's the leader of the birds.
You know her well.
No,
she's finally...
Lugia's male.
Oh, whatever.
Actually, Lugia's genderless, but... Anyway.
Genderless, just like Mewtwo.
Next time, more stuff, guys. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.